So I welcome you all for this class number 3. So yesterday we discussed a formula for angle between the radius vector and the tangent in the previous class, and also we solved some problems on that. And also we discussed in the previous class how to find the angle between two curves. So angle between two curves will be the angle between their tangents. Then what is the condition for two curves to intersect orthogonally or perpendicularly? That condition also we discussed in the previous class. So in this class we are going to consider few more problems on angle between the radius vector and the tangent. So here problem number 2 is find the angle between the radius vector and the tangent. Radius vector and the tangent, here we should get tangent, and also determine the slope of the tangent for the following curves. So that's what we have to do. So in previous case we are supposed to find the angle between the radius vector and the tangent, that's all. So we are supposed to find what is phi. But here with this phi we have to determine the slope of the tangent at the given points. So I have not written here complete statement, so I have just written the main thing. You have to find the slope of the tangent. So while deriving the expression for phi, you might have observed this one. I have said this one: tan psi represents slope of the tangent or slope of the curve. So this is what we have to determine. Actually you will be given with the curve, you have to find phi, that is the first step. The second step is you have to determine tan psi. So how can you find tan psi? First you need to find psi, right? So I have to recall this result: psi equal to phi plus theta. This is what you have to recall. So first find phi, then psi. So this is first one, this is second. You have to recall this result. Then you have to take tan on both sides, you get slope of the tangent. So that's what we have to do. Keep that in mind. Now let us come to the first curve. R equal to a times of 1 plus cos theta. Okay, the first step is you have to write the given things. Given R equal to a times of 1 plus cos theta. Given R equal to a times of 1 plus cos theta. As I said, we'll take log on both sides, then differentiate it. Taking log on both sides, I'll get log R. I can't write each and every step clearly, so because just to save the time, taking log, I'll get log R equal to log of a times of 1 plus cos theta. Now I have to simplify this expression, or else you can directly differentiate it, no problem. If you directly differentiate, 1 by a times of 1 plus cos theta into a into derivative of 1 plus cos theta again. That is you can do, or else you can simplify this expression using the property log AB equal to log A plus log B. So this will be log R equal to log A plus log of 1 plus cos theta. Now differentiating both sides with respect to theta, differentiating both sides with respect to theta. So left hand side will get derivative of log R, that is 1 by R, into derivative of R with respect to theta, derivative of R with respect to theta, that is dr by d theta, equal to log A, a constant term, differentiating that you get 0, plus log of 1 plus cos theta, differentiating will get 1 by 1 plus cos theta, into derivative of 1 plus cos theta, derivative of 1 is 0, plus derivative of cos theta is minus sin theta. So left hand side 1 by r into dr by d theta you can write as cot phi equal to minus sin theta divided by 1 plus cos theta. As I said in the previous class, I can write sin theta as 2 sin theta by 2 into cos theta by 2. And similarly, 1 plus cos theta will be 2 times of cos square of theta by 2. Now that implies here cot phi equal to minus 2 sin of theta by 2 into cos of theta by 2 divided by 2 cos square of theta by 2. So one term you can cancel here. So this one term cancel with this, 2 get cancelled. So you remain with cot phi equal to cot phi equal to minus sin agirutte sin of theta by 2 divided by cos of theta by 2, that is tan of theta by 2. Now one side you have tan of theta by 2, another side you have cot phi. Either you have to write this left hand side in terms of tan so that you can compare the angles, or you can write the right hand side in terms of cot so that you can compare angles. So for that purpose you have to use a standard result. That standard result says that minus tan theta equal to cot of pi by 2 plus theta. Minus tan theta equal to cot of pi by 2 plus theta. How can we use this here? See, I have here minus tan theta, here minus of tan theta by 2. If I apply this result here, I'll get cot phi equal to cot of pi by 2 plus whatever the angle I have here, that I have to write theta by 2. So cot, don't cancel it. Please don't do that. You are just comparing, not canceling anything. So I'll get phi equal to pi by 2 plus theta by 2. This is one part of the solution. So we have determined angle between the radius vector and the tangent. Now I'll come into the problem statement. So here there is one more additional line at theta equal to pi by 3. So if you are supposed to find the angle between the radius vector and the tangent only, then whatever we have done, that is enough. If you are supposed to find angle between the radius vector and the tangent only, then whatever we have done, that is enough. For the further part, I have to consider this theta equal to pi by 3 value. So sumne nim confusion agutte anta idan later barithadini. I'm just writing this later to avoid the confusion. ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಉದ್ದಾದಷ್ಟು ಹೆದರ್ಕೋಬಿಡ್ತೀರ ನೀವು. ದೆನ್ ನಾವು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಟ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೈ. ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಸೈ ಫಸ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ ದಟ್. ವಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಸೈ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಫೈ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಥೀಟಾ. We know that psi equal to phi plus theta, but phi we have determined, so that implies psi equal to pi by 2 plus theta by 2 plus this theta I have to carry. So that implies I got psi equal to pi by 2 plus 3 theta by 2. Substitute for theta now. substitute for theta, but theta is given as pi by 3. So psi equal to pi by 2 plus 3 by 2 into pi by 3. So I will get pi by 2 plus pi by 2, that is 2 pi by 2. So I get psi equal to pi. I want slope of the tangent, so just take tan on both sides. Taking tan on both sides, I will get tan psi equal to tan phi, that is 0. So slope of the tangent is 0. So that's complete the first problem or first curve. So second curve, r cos square of theta by 2 equal to a at theta equal to 2 pi by 3. So the complete statement is given right now. R cos square theta by 2 equal to a at theta equal to 2 pi by 3. How can we find angle between the radius vector and the tangent? Let us see. Solution. Given r into cos square of theta by 2 equal to a. R into cos square of theta by 2 equal to a. As usual, taking log on both sides, log of r times of cos square of theta by 2 equal to log a. So this I can write as log r plus, here I can use the property log a power m is equal to m into log a. So if I use that property, log of cos square of theta by 2 will be 2 log of cos of theta by 2 equal to log a. Now differentiating with respect to theta on both sides. So you will get the first term on the left hand side as 1 by r into dr by d theta plus 2 into log of cos theta by 2, right? So 1 by cos of theta by 2 into derivative of cos, that is minus sine of theta by 2 into derivative of inner function. So theta by 2 differentiating will get 1 by 2 equal to 0. So here you can cancel with this 2 with this. So I'll get cot phi, this term is cot phi, minus sin theta by 2 by cos theta by 2, that is tan theta by 2 equal to 0, or that is cot phi equal to tan of theta by 2. So one side you got cot, another side you got tan. So the result I can use here is, I will write here, I have to write tan in terms of cot. For that, tan theta by 2 equal to tan theta equal to minus cot of pi by 2 plus theta. This result, can I use this? Yes, I can use this. So this implies then cot phi equal to minus cot of pi by 2 plus theta by 2. cot phi equal to minus cot of pi by 2 plus theta by 2. Sorry, something has happened, not this one. Tan theta equal to, sorry, I'll write it again. Tan theta equal to cot of pi by 2 minus theta. So when you get here plus, then you get minus sign here. When you get minus sign, you have to use opposite signs there. So it will be, we have some changes here. Cot of, I'll write it in black. Cot of pi by 2 minus theta by 2. Then comparing angles on both sides, we'll get phi equal to pi by 2 minus theta by 2. Okay, now I got phi. Next, we know that psi equal to phi plus theta, and phi we got here, so psi equal to pi by 2 minus theta by 2. Next we had to carry theta as it is, so we'll get psi equal to pi by 2 minus theta by 2 plus theta, that will be plus theta by 2. Now it is given that theta equal to 2 pi by 3, so I have to substitute for theta. Substituting for theta, we get psi equal to pi by 2 plus, I'll write 1 by 2 into theta, then 2 pi by 3. So 2 get cancelled, pi by 2 plus pi by 3 will get, that is 5 pi by 6. 5 pi by 6, or it will be 150 degree. So tan psi will be minus, taking tan on both sides, minus 1 by root 3. So that is the required answer. So this is about the second curve. Next, let us consider one more. 2a by r equal to 1 minus cos theta. See, 2a by r equal to 1 minus cos theta. Here, there is no value for theta, I think. At theta equal to 2 pi by 3. At theta equal to 2 pi by 3. Now, we need to find angle between the radius vector and the tangent, then slope of the tangent to this curve. Solution given 2a by r equal to 1 minus cos theta. So as usual, taking log on both sides, you will be having log 2a. I am directly writing this with using the properties. Log 2a minus log r equal to log of 1 minus cos theta. Now differentiating with respect to theta, we get log 2a, you will get 0. Constant term anyway, that will be 0. Minus 1 by r into dr by d theta equal to log of 1 minus cos theta. So 1 divided by 1 minus cos theta into derivative of minus cos theta, you get sin theta. So this implies minus cot phi equal to, numerator can be written as 2 times of sine of theta by 2 into cos of theta by 2 divided by 1 minus cos theta, right? That will be 2 sine square of theta by 2. Now, cancelling corresponding terms, sin theta by 2, one term cancels in the denominator and 2 to get cancelled. So, we will get minus cot phi equal to cos of theta by 2 by sin of theta by 2, that is cot of theta by 2 minus cot phi equal to cot of theta by 2. So this I can write as, for a comparison of angles, minus cot phi I can write as cot of minus phi equal to cot of theta by 2. Now you can compare corresponding angles to get therefore we get phi equal to, we get minus phi equal to theta by 2 or phi equal to minus theta by 2. Next, recall, or you have to call psi function, right? Next, we know that psi equal to phi plus theta, but phi is minus theta by 2. Substituting for phi, you will get psi equal to minus theta by 2 plus theta, that is psi equal to theta by 2. But it is given that theta equal to 2 pi by 3. Substituting for theta, you will get psi equal to 1 by 2 into 2 pi by 3. So we get two get cancelled, pi by 3 we get, that is 60 degree. So we have psi equal to pi by 3. Taking tan on both sides, we get tan psi equal to tan pi by 3, that is root 3. So finally we have the curve r equal to a times of 1 plus sin theta d, r equal to a times of 1 plus sin theta at theta equal to pi by 2. At theta equal to pi by 2 solution. Given r equal to a times of 1 plus sin theta. Yes, let us write the given curve first. R equal to a times of 1 plus sin theta. Then taking log on both sides. So we'll get log r equal to, I can write this directly, I hope, log a plus log of 1 plus sin theta. Now differentiating with respect to theta, we'll get 1 by r into dr by d theta equal to log a will be 0 plus, in the denominator, 1 plus sin theta, numerator will be cos theta. So here we'll get cot phi equal to cos theta by 1 plus sin theta. If you had 1 plus cos theta in the denominator, then simplification is easy. But for 1 plus sin theta, you have to use many standard results, and we need many simplifications to find or to simplify this expression, I don't worry about that simplification. What is my intention is, I need to find the slope of the tangent at the given value of theta, right? So I'll directly substitute that theta here. At theta equal to pi by 2. Usually sai bandaga substitute martidvi, illile substitute maadibirtene. So I'll get cot phi equal to cos of pi by 2 divided by 1 plus sin of pi by 2. So substituting for this, I'll get 0. So cot phi is 0, therefore phi equal to pi by 2. Now recall psi. We know that psi equal to phi plus theta by 2, sorry, phi plus theta. Now substitute for phi. So I'll get psi equal to pi by 2 plus theta. That implies, again substituting for theta, psi equal to pi by 2 plus pi by 2. That is phi. Therefore, slope of the tangent is tan psi equal to tan pi equal to 0. Tan 180 degree, you get 0. So with this, we are going to end up our discussion on angle between the radius vector and the tangent and finding the slope of the tangent at the given value of theta, or given at the point indicated, you can just say. So in the next class, we shall discuss how to find the angle between the curves. So that will be next.